Then next part is synopsis tickle. So for the basic tickle, I believe you already know it, or if you want some reference, maybe there are already pre-recorded videos which you can go through it that will be provided. Let's directly jump to the synopsis tickle part. What they say as synopsis tickle. Let's take one example. We will be discussing that part throughout the lab sessions because there is no end to it. But yeah, as a starting point, let me give you one such example today, and we will get some idea what is synopsis tickle all about. So I have this prime time shell kept open, and there's this one routed database which I have loaded with the spef file constraints and .lib and everything. So let me check some violations here. So it is report constraints to check all the violators, basically report constraints hyphen all violators. So I have, if I just scroll up, I have all these violations. So these violations are about what category? Let me just see that. So it is min capacitance type of violations. Then we have other violations. So let me dump this file. So basically, task is I want to know the all violations count. How many violations are there in my current design? So how we will do that? So we have already dumped this part. Like Jay Krishna said, that dump the all violators into a file. Till there he was correct. Then we can do a grep here. Grep violated on this file. So I will get all the violated lines here. Now I can do WC minus L. That's very correct. Thanks a lot. So there are actually total 728 violations. So this is one way which I have done. I have extracted the report into the into a file, and then I did a use of grep. But I do not want to do that part. I wanted to run it inside this. And now if I want to know, so here, if you see in this file, let me open this file. This is all violators, right? I did not specify it. I am searching for min delay. If I am searching for max delay, I am searching for max transition, min transition, or recovery removal, right? I did not specify that. If I want to do that part will not be able to be done using grep, right? Because removal is just written here. And then just to count only the lines below removal till max capacitance, I have to write actually a code of multiple lines. It will not be that easy, correct? So how can we do it inside prime time? Okay, so now let me just discuss that part. So how do we do it? So here, even this redirection is done using a prime time command that is called redirect. So there's a command called redirect. What it does, it redirects the output of a command to a file. It can be a file, it can be a variable, it can be a channel, it can be written out to a file which is parallelly working as a log file. It can be anything, right? So even what I did here using this operator, I could have done this using redirect command also. So now how I am going to do, I will do redirect to a variable, all this collection. Okay, so how I will do is redirect, I will take a variable, maybe rpt all violators. Like this, this is the variable name which I'm giving it. Now, I have to execute a command that is this report time report constraints all violators that will be executed here. It is done. It is defining a new variable and it is printed. Now, if I do puts this particular variable just to see, the value is there, right? All that what has been dumped into this file also. The same thing I am able to see in this variable. Till here it is correct. It is, you all guys are following. This redirect command hyphen variable, I give a variable name, and then the command I gave it inside the curly braces that I wanted to create a collection of into this variable. Now let's make use of regular expression, as surgeon was mentioning. Regular expression hyphen all violated inside that variable, that is RPT all violations. So it is using the regular expression inside this variable. It is only searching for violated as 728. Now again, like as I was saying, that if I wanted to search only for the max capacitance or min delay or max delay, if I want to do separation of that, that is also not possible here, right? So what I need to do instead, so what I can do if I want to make it as a command, like, so what all what so now what let's understand how do we make the command. So even if this report timing, how these are being created, so these are basically functions. Okay, so let me now create a function. So here function is nothing but proc. So I will do proc, maybe let me write it in a different file, proc. I want to have total violating points, total negative violating violations dot tickle, something like this. And I will here write proc get underscore total negative violations. Let me give this empty arguments. I'm giving it. Then what I want to have redirect hyphen variable. I will give a variable name. What I gave RPT violations, I'm giving new name. Let me just see what name I gave. All violations. Okay. Violations. I'm giving it a new name. Then I want to execute the script, that is report constraints hyphen all violators. Right. Here I have given this. Done. Then next part was regular expression hyphen all violated inside this variable. Done. Proc closed. So just let's save this. And if I just apply this inside PrimeTime shell, you can directly source the file or you can copy paste it. That is also fine. So now this proc is created. Get underscore TNV. See, it is working. So basically, I have created a processor. I don't have to repeatedly work on this. And now, even if my violations, let's suppose these are all violators, if I'm working on the fixes, okay, max changes and fix, I have done the setup and whole fixes. So my count will get reduced. Then if I want to get the updated number, so I just need to use this command. Basically, I have created this command as a function, and basically a processor, and this is basically doing this part. It will reset this variable and it will search for only the violations across all the things, and then it will give me the value, that is 728. That's what we have. Now, as I said, if I want to update this for specific things, so what I need to make is, like, I want the violation count for the min delay or max delay or removal, something like that. So what I have to give is basically, when I do this report constraints, I give all violators. Here I can give the options like this max. If it is max transition or max capacitance, I can give these things like max transition, min capacitance, something like that. Or if it is the check type, I can give the delay type. Here it is the max delay groups, not delay type in the report timing command. Okay. So here I can give this options. So I have to give this options after the command. Basically, what I need to do is, I have to make, if I want to use the same processor, same command, I have to make this as argumentative. Okay. So for that, what I need to update is, let me just make a copy of it. Okay. So I want to copy the line number 1 to 4, Y shift P. So, and let me just comment it out. I will not use this. Now here I want to make it argumentative. So it will be, let me make a variable name as delay underscore type, or not delay type, it should be violation type. Then I have to use it here as a hyphen switch. With a hyphen dollar violation type. Let me just wrap it around the braces that does not get confused. And then it should be correct. Yes. Now, what I need to do, let me just update this processor definition inside the prime time. Done. Now, what I need to do is when I'm using this, if I will use that directly, so basically it is asking for an argument. That's what it says. Should be get TNV space violation type as argument, right? Because that is what I have defined. So get TNV, I want to search for, let's suppose, max transition. There is zero max transition violation. Max cap. There are max capacitance 209. If I want to search for min delay, this should work. There are 89. If I want to search for max delay, I can give max delay groups. There is no setup violation, it seems. Let me just check it, cross check. Report analysis coverage. Yeah, there is no setup violations, no gating violations, no output setup. Correct. So that's why it is giving max delay as 0. Min delay is giving 89. So yes, you can see hold violation, there is 89 violations. Then there are min pulse width. No violation. Okay, it is untested. Violations is here on the removal. So okay, let's verify this removal part also. So I think for removal also we have this switch. Okay, need to give removal group as a name. 30. Correct. Seems interesting.